The following presentation will be brought to you by Victor Newman. Enjoy. I've been told I was cold, like I don't have a soul, like this life that I lived, that it didn't take a toll, like I ain't ever fold the best hand when I was winning. Devil sitting and grinning, like nigga, I'm all in. I know this bitch bluffing. No, she ain't got nothing, but she got a pussy and she oh so confident. Say she from LA, but keep that confidential. I told her I'm from Cleveland through the story, that's essential. We had all the potential. I went Thanos with this left hand, took Cavern for soul. Now she deaf for any other man. No funerals for outlaws, you hoes getting. No second chance, I don't sing, can't dance. I can bring you romance, it's so true, it's so deep. The first cut, it still be blue. Pull it out, it's all red. 7 days, she ain't even dead. And all I see is purple rain. I don't even feel the pain. This knife in my back got me thinking, we the perfect match. So I figured it out, right? I brought another mic. Right, so this is the one I'm using right now. Been testing it out. And so yesterday, right, I was trying to get my volumes and things correct. And so I spent like almost an hour just sitting here, you know, testing different distances and things like that. And so, you know, that took a lot out of me mentally, you know. Or, you know, just when you're ready to talk, you're ready to talk, you know, you got your subject matter ready and you just want to get it out. And so that took me out, you know, of the current mind state that I was in when I was writing. And so by the time I actually got to talking, right, I got all off topic and, you know, went somewhere that I didn't want to go, right, talking about my son. And so now that happened, right, because I didn't sleep, didn't, you know, haven't been thinking about that shit, you know, the whole time. And then I think I even messed up on the time that it was supposed to be published. You know, it was supposed to be 7:08 a.m. I don't know if I put it for like 7:08 today, you know. So anyway, all of that shit was on my mind. And then the thing is, my brother, right, been telling y'all about this shit, you know what I'm saying? And, right, and my whole point to this would be, this is how you remind me of what I really am. This is how you remind me of what I really am. I love that song by Nickelback. Right, it might be in my top 20, you know, top 15 maybe. But like, so my sister called me, you know, right? Now y'all remember, y'all too, that, you know, she gave me some money, right, that led to an argument. And so I have been texting her and calling her, and I was going, right, I have a car so I can drop it off to her. But she hadn't texted me back, she hadn't called me or anything. Except for when my brother, you know what I'm saying, got in his situation. So this is how we've been talking again, you know. And so my mother has been deferring, you know, everything to my sister with my brother, you know. And she's been doing that for a long time, you know what I mean, like with me being sick, you know, instead of, you know, she won't come and see you, but she sent my stepfather or sent my sister, you know what I mean. And then when I get mad and blow up on them, like, they don't really give a fuck, they only doing it because she told them to, you know saying. They try to act like that I'm wrong, you know, and try to like, I couldn't because I care, you know what I'm saying? But when she mad at me, then they all mad at me, you know what I mean? Same thing with my brother, you know? And then like, and so this is how, you know, like, I'm changing the name of the show, you know, cause, right, I told y'all about my brother, and then I told you about my son, you know. It's like, I don't know what the fuck I'm supposed to be talking about, you know? And then I join all these groups and things like that, and you know, and they over there, you know, everybody, you know, they're not, it's not natural, you know, they don't just want to talk for the sake of talking, you know what I mean? Like, they want to know what's gonna make them some money, what's the subject matter that people are interested in, you know? It's not just people coming to their show because, you know, it's their show and you just want to hear what the motherfucker got to say, you know? Like, I watch Joe Rogan, you know what I mean? He always has a guest, you know what I mean? Like, if I had a guest, believe me, I should be popping, you know what I mean? Because, right, I talk real, you know what I mean? And I don't let nobody talk to me not like that, you know? Not like a human, not like, you know, I ask you a question, you ask me a question back, you know? Or like my brother, you know, I'm gonna get into that, I guess, you know what I'm saying? Because this nigga here, you know what I'm saying? This nigga here. I'm like, you know, so, right, my sister called me. Right, so I give him some money, right? So he's supposed to be going. He lived with this broad, right? And I told y'all to, you know, and they've been together for almost 10 years and things like that. And so she tired of him or however that, I don't know, you know what I mean? It's like, you know, the power dynamic has shifted, you know? And so, and it's so funny, you know what I'm saying? A woman is a woman, big, small, cute, right? It's no, like, people used to get mad at me, or my brother actually, right? Like, when I say that, it really not any ugly women, you know? And I'm talking about like 90%, right, of everything, right? So, you know, you have those special people, you know, that just, you know, the features didn't come together, you know? But for the most part, to me, you know, I could always see some type of beauty in a woman, you know what I'm saying? Like, you should listen, right, my sister or my mother talk about, well, my sister talk about me and my choices of women. But so, right, so me talking about weather, talking about fucking world events, Trump, and all that other shit, like, right, like, I don't give a fuck about none of that, right? Like, I'm changing the name of the show to Dead Man Walking. Shout out to Antoine Matthews. Right, so everything comes full circle, right? Because my name was Wisdom, his name was Mastermind. Then my name, it's like Rich Matrix, like Immortal, right? Because that's the first rap we wrote. Like, after I wrote mine, he wrote one, you know? And then that's how we became rap partners, you know? And so, because I always said I couldn't die, you know? And so his thing was Dead Man Walking, you know what I mean? It's like two sides of the same coin type of thing, you know what I mean? Like my mother would say, you can't kill me and I won't die. So, you know, fuck the positivity, fuck all of y'all, fuck the world, right? Over the rap about it, want to hear it, here it go, you know, been sent here to spread the word, fuck you and fuck the world, you know? Right, I was gonna, right, it was another beginning of a rap, you know what I'm saying, that I was gonna say, right? But anyway, rapper means writer, definition, describe a dog, you know, delusion of grandeur, you understand that? D-O-G, delusions of grandeur, people. This is what the fuck are you listening to, you know what I'm saying? Right, ain't no fucking happy ending to this shit, you know, I'm tired of, right, my brother made me realize who the fuck I am, you know, because he come over here, you know, right. So, my sister called me, right, asking me, do I still have that money, right, that I owe her? And like, and this is the whole point, because like, I'm broke as fuck, but I held on to that money that I owe her because I don't want to hear her mouth, you know what I mean? I'm just trying to get it to her so I don't have to hear her mouth, you know? And so, I say, yeah, because I know what she about to say, yeah. She said, give it to Patrick, you know what I'm saying? Because he needed it, so. Now, listen, right? So I gave a couple of dollars yesterday, you know what I'm saying? Money to catch the bus, a couple of dollars, buy a couple of cigarettes and a beer, right? He not supposed to be drinking, you know what I'm saying? And this is the thing, right? And so I tell them, right, you know, like, this force field that I'm holding up, it's fragile, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is all a fucking facade. You know what I'm saying? It don't take for me much for me to break. You know what I'm saying? And you trying to put pressure on me. You know what I'm saying? Like, you 33 years old, and you know what I'm saying? And you acting like the world is, you know what I'm saying, is ending and things like that. You know what I'm saying? Right. You wasn't supposed to drink, so you went to jail, and the girl, you know what I'm saying, put you in jail. So, you know what I'm saying, like, the relationship is over because she been trying, you know what I'm saying, she been putting herself in a position of power. You know what I mean? So now she got all the power, and you still don't want to do what she says. So get the fuck out, nigga. You know what I mean? Oh, you want to put your hands on me? Oh yeah, you really got to go now. So, you know, this nigga, right, when them doors closed, like Dre died on motherfucking power, you know what I'm saying? Like, that was one of the fear, you know what I'm saying? I had that fear before, you know what I'm saying? Claustrophobic, and the nigga can't stop going to jail. What the fuck is wrong with you? You know what I'm saying? Like, I've been retarded all my life. So I'm done trying to play the motherfucking, you know what I'm saying, trying to give the good word before I go. You know what I'm saying? Like, still nobody care. You know what I mean? Like, I done had this podcast for 3 months. Ain't nobody fucking listening. You know what I'm saying? I got one follower. One follower, you know what I mean? Two people in Australia, you know what I mean, checked on the shit, probably because I put Trump in the title. And then this girl from India clicked on it because she got a page, you know, some beautiful ass Indian girls on that damn page, though, you know. Shout out to India. Beautiful girls, right? But, like, everybody wants to be the hero of the story, you know. So I wanted to be a hero, you know, and whatever, you know what I mean? Like, I done cried on here. I done told y'all shit that I'm not supposed to be telling y'all, you know, and like, for what, you know what I mean? Like, actually, for what, you know? So it's like, it's the diary of a dead man, you know what I'm saying? I'm a dead man walking, you know what I mean? I'm just talking to y'all, you know, before all that shit. And like, so I was watching this show, right, The Deuce, that used to come on HBO. You know, it ran for like three years, maybe four. I think it was maybe only three, because, like, you know, the shit's so deep, it don't, you know, like, it don't take 5-6 years, you know what I'm saying, for you to know how all it works out. But it was the beginning, like, it was the sex trade. It was New York, right? And it was called The Deuce because I guess, you know, like, that's what the concentration of hookers, you know, used to be at in the early 70s. So, you know, it shows the pimps and the hookers, you know, and how life was and things like that. And then it transcends into, you know, the porn industry, all that stuff that used to be in Manhattan, because I went to New York when they still had that shit. You know, you just walk up and put a quarter in, you know, and it's a million people outside, but it's 1,000 fucking porno shops, you know, littering, well, you know, I mean, prominent throughout the whole area. And so, like, it showed the rise of that, you know, the coin machines, you know, the porno shops, you know, you go in there. Like, I did that shit before. I told a whole bunch of my dudes, cause, like, you know, porn used to be, you know, like, special. Like, so I knew somewhere where you could see the shit at. So I took all these niggas down there before. I don't want to talk about that. Cause, right, cause, like, it's always funny. Like, what make you turn on the gay scene? You know what I'm saying? You have a choice here. You know what I'm saying? It asks you what you want to see. You know what I'm saying? So why did you push that button? You know what I'm saying? And then why did you call niggas over there to say, hey, look at this shit, get the fuck out of here? I ain't naming no names, but anyway, so The Deuce showed all of that. And then it goes, you know, right, it shows, like, the dying off of the pimp, you know, and the rise of the beeper. You know what I'm saying? Them hoes got beepers. They're like, nigga, I don't need no pimp, right? The sex brothels, the massage parlors, you know, things like that. And then it transitions into the porno, right? And so, in particular, there was this one girl. right? And show you from the time she got off the bus, you know, all the way into, you know, the end of her story. And so, you know, she used to have a black pimp, you know, and this nigga got mad because she started being more independent. And he, you know, he seen like the white man is now, you know, it's like, right, like the white man is like a dying pimp. Still trying to hold on to his hoes and shit, you know what I'm saying? So, right, and so he, you know, he made a lot of mistakes, you know, he didn't adjust with the times, and so, you know, he died off. And so she kept going, you know, and she became a porn star. Now she became a big porn star, you know what I mean? And so, like, she went through all the drugs and, you know, all that art, you know, that how that story ends, you know how that story ends. And so, you know, she was doing all of that, and then she was like at her rock bottom, you know. And then she tried to do it. It was so funny because I remember in the 80s, it was this porn girl, right? This blunt keep going out, but y'all ain't gotta keep on hearing me light it. So in the 80s, it was this porn bra, did this movie called Debbie Does Dallas, right? And you know, so because like so from the 70s, you know, they didn't did all this shit, you know, they didn't ass fuck, you know, they didn't did all this, but it wasn't really like they did orgies, right? But the gangbang was new. And so like when she was trying to get back into, you know, the porn industry, because she tried to go legit, right? Because she could sing, you know, she played the guitar and everything like that, but like nobody would let her move on, nobody would let her transition out of what she used to be, you know what I mean? Like, this is how you remind me of what I really am. And so she gave up, you know, and so she went back to doing that. And so so now they want, you know, they want DPs, they want this, they want that, and she doing all this shit, and she like, what the fuck? And and so it was like, so she, it was trying to do this one movie or whatever, she like, I need a movie, I need a gig, and then like, you know, we gonna do this. And she like they want to see something they ain't never seen before. She like, what the fuck have they never seen before? Like, I've been fucked every such way, every which way but loose, you know what I mean? And then she jump in the van and here go 15 niggas, you know what I mean? And so she had to go through that. And then it's another girl, like, right, Maggie, and like she was based on a true person, you know, that made some type of good erotica movie without sex in it, but she wanted the sex, right? She another one that couldn't escape, you know, like, right, I'm starting to feel, my brother made me feel like I can't escape, you know what I'm saying, who I am, you know. And so she, so the young one contacted the older one because she made herself right from the streets, you know, she became a director, you know, and she was directing porn, stopped hooking, stopped doing, she went to porn and she stopped doing pornos also. And so her story arc was, at the end of the story, this bitch get the rich nigga, you know what I'm saying, rich white boy, wanna take care of her, you know, but she want to make this movie, you know. And so she done made all these promises and deals and things like that, and then they done made her come out of retirement, you know what I'm saying, like, they didn't have to do her like that, you know, but they made her come out of retirement. Candy was her name, made her come out of retirement to front the movie, for, you know, front the money for the movie, part of the money, like, she still had to raise, like, they gotta raise money, like, this is how integrity gets lost, you know, from the writer to the studio, you know, because there's all these backhanded deals that they gotta make, you know, you they make you sell your soul. But in like, and this is in the porn industry, so imagine what they do, you know, with a real movie, you know. And so they so she, you know, she did her part, so she gotta talk these other young people into doing this shit, like, cause the girl didn't want to do it, and she like, I ain't gonna make you, you know, and stuff like that. I mean, it's reverse psychology. I mean, it's still a mind fuck. She wanted to do it, but she understand if she don't do it, you know what I mean? And so, Lori Madison, yeah, that was her name, Lori Madison. That was the other, that's the young girl, you know, this you know, on her side, going through her stuff, because she moved out to California, you know, when the porn industry changed over from New York, you know, and California took over, right? You know, and so Lori called Candy, and so she make Candy making that new movie, you know, and she need somebody like her, you know, a star, because she won't fuck, but she made it like this, the fucking is secondary, okay? Like, this is, they used to try to do this stuff. This is how you got Deep Throat in the fucking movie theaters in the 70s, you know what I mean? But they trying to make erotica, right? Like, you know, it's a whole soft porn, right? What you would call it now. Like, but this is before that. It was like real fucking, but a real story also, you know? Like, so they just cut out the real fucking and made it a real story, you know? So you get that part, all right? So, you know, she, so Lori calls Candy. So Candy needs Lori. She like, yeah, you know what I mean? She paid for a room for her. Oh yeah, she came back to New York, right? That was the whole thing. Lori came back to New York. You know, bottom level. You know what I'm saying? She's at her bottom, you know, and she called her, so they make a deal. She go see Candy, and Candy give her some money for the hotel room. You know, and oops, sorry about that. So Candy give her some money for the hotel room, and she I don't know what she do with the money. I don't know what happened to the money. She might have still had the money, you know. But she go out on like Broadway or like, okay, my fault, because I don't know, like, you know, it seems like probably the Deuce is probably off Broadway somewhere. But anyway, like, she go back probably to the Deuce, okay? Because this is the thing, like, you know, like, this is, like, the last, one of the last episodes. It might have been the last episode. I think it was. And so, she go back to the Deuce, you know, reminiscing, you know? She's just going, you know what I mean? She's reminiscing. She's just going through some things. And so she pick up a trick, right? You know, she just go out there and just get to flossing like the old days, you know what I mean? Like, because she had money. Because she was, in this fictitious world, she was probably, like, one of the biggest porn stars, you know what I mean? So everybody knew her, you know what I mean, for that time, you know? And so it would be like a Linda Lovelace type of situation, the girl that made Deep Throat, you know what I mean? I'm sure that would be like her character, or however, a thousand of them like that, right? So anyway, my point is this. So she pick up the trick, they go back to the hotel. Oh yeah, right. And so, like, this is like she like from the late 70s, you know what I mean? This is 80 something now, right? Like mid 80s. And so the dude asked her, like, you know, how much, you know what I'm saying? She like 75. He like, damn, you cheap, you know what I'm saying? He like, you cheap. So he her up and get the money. She like, plus the hotel, you know what I mean? So another $40, I don't know, you know. So they fuck, right? So he leaves. She's sitting there. She go to the dresser, put some money and a credit card on the dresser. She go over, she sit on the bed. The camera is right there, right? She sit up there, she take out a bottle of Coke, you know, and then she about to sniff it. Then she put it back, she screw it back on, she pull out the gun and blew her head off. And that's the end of the story. That shit fucked me up, you know what I mean? That's my whole point. That's how it ends. Got nothing else to say about that. It says in my notes, 12:118, a leader doesn't lead out front, right? They lead from the side, the coach. So I guess women will always be the real leaders, but men are the front men, the muscle. We do what they don't want or can't do. Every gang has a mouthpiece, a speaker. It's the vampire and wolf scenario. They created us to protect them. But as always, but as all things go, we grew tired of serving. Stop. 12:1-18. So my brother, right, so my sister asks me, do I have the money? Yeah, right. So it goes to my brother. Now, when he left yesterday, right, gave him the money, he supposed to be, you know, because I would have gave him a ride, right? I would have gave him a ride, you know, to go out there, because I had called the girl, right? She didn't block my number. She ain't answering no calls from nobody, right? But he broke her phone, so he say, right, she might have got a new number. So, you know, I would have took him out there and all of that, right? But, you know, he wants to be, to me, slick, right? Because I'm not talking about a kid, even though I've known him since, you know what I'm saying? And when you tell somebody they always been this way, they get mad, you know what I'm saying? But he's a grown man, right? And so, you know, he wants to try to go make up, right, to me. You know what I'm saying? I already know what he did try to do, you know what I'm saying? Try to go out there and try to make up, because, you know what I'm saying, that's what he do. Like me, if I fuck up, I'll walk away like, fuck it. Fuck you too, I'm sorry. But, alright, I understand if you don't want to fuck with me no more. But it's like certain people, they don't take no for an answer. And he's one of these people, you know what I'm saying? It has to be, you know what I'm saying? You know, it has to be a way out, you know? The lawnmower man, the real lawnmower man. So, this nigga, so, right, so that, I guess, that didn't work out, right? You know, he wear like a 10 and a half, 11, right? He only like 5'7", 5'8", right? So I wear a 12, you know what I mean? So he got my shoes on and gave him my hoodie, you know what I mean? She didn't put him out, you know what I mean? Like when you go to jail with what you got on. And so now I don't like the scenario of like, you know, bitch, give me my shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, you don't want to mess with me. Open the door. You know what I mean? But she know him, right? Because he going to try to talk his way into it. I don't know. Maybe she just done, right? When y'all done, you know? And like, niggas got to understand that, you know? Like, you know, like, you don't just, you know, you can't get blood from a rock. You can't, all of the, whatever analogy that goes into a woman being done, you know? And so, you know, we can always see it from the outside, you know? Because I've been there, right? And that's the thing about, right, when it's family, when it's, you know, if you share the last name, you share the blood, you share the pain, you know what I mean? And so from his side, you know, because I don't want to deal with this shit, is, oh, yeah, I didn't do nothing. I ain't did nothing. And what did I do? And, you know, I'm just trying to. And so this is the thing, right? So, you know, I give the money that I owe my sister to my brother, right? Now, this is today, okay? Right, so I made that episode, right? 1 hour and fucking 20 minutes talking about my son, and like just keep on talking, trying to explain, like you can't, you know, and like the end of the result is, right, I lost everything, you know what I mean? And I was wrong, you know what I mean? It's like, and I don't want to, you know, like, I was thinking about it all fucking night. Like, what do I say? Like, after this shit come out, you know, like, I'll, you know, you keep trying to explain because you can't. You know what I mean? It's like, you fucked up, and that's that. You know what I mean? Like, this is why I got probation, because I concurred. You know what I'm saying? I told the judge, I fucked up. You know what I mean? Like, and it's not, you know what I'm saying? It's not what you think. You know, it's not like, you know, I'm not that guy, you know, like, give me my son, like, give me a chance, you know, and she gave me a chance, you know, and like I said before, right, here I go, but life goes on, you know, and trying to build a life, trying to get my wife back, you know, I thought that I would have had time, you know what I'm saying, and so I went, like, I was only out for 4 months from January to June. Again, I'm telling you, it was within a few days of the first time date of the previous year, okay? And so me with my all this stuff, like, I take responsibility for things, because it'd be like, I seen it, like, it has to be, it has to happen this way because I fucked up in this date. You know what I'm saying? This is the exact same date that I went to jail this other time, you know, and all, you know, all of that big conspiracy in my head type of thing, you know. But, you know, it's taking too much blame, but it's take, you know, because all the blame, you can't take all the blame, you know. But where do you draw the line, you know? And then it's just when people don't take any accountability or any responsibility is when I have a problem, you know. And my mother is like that, my sister and my brother is like that. Like, if anything, y'all two hear me debate with myself about being wrong and right all the fucking time, you know what I mean? Like, that's not right, that's right, that's not right, you know. And like, is it a reason or excuse, you know what I mean? Because you cannot, you know, right? So it's just about a story arc, right? And the thing is, you know, I give him $50, right? I was up all night, like I said before, stressing. Then my neighbor wanna play fucking music to shake my windows 4 o'clock in the morning, you know what I'm saying? Then I go knock on the door like, are you mad at me? Like, what the fuck, nigga? You know what I'm saying? And then he had his bitch over there that I didn't used to fuck, you know what I'm saying? And so he like, oh, we don't talk, we don't do the music, you know, we don't complain about music, and close the door. So I gotta come back up here and sit up here like, okay, it's cool. Still thinking about me, you know, talking about my son for a fucking hour. I don't know, it wasn't even a whole hour. It just feels like it, you know what I mean? It just feels. And I never talked about that, you know what I mean? Especially, you know, like, it's so funny, like, on my website, I put out these so-called sermons. I had these sermons, right? Like, I was supposed to speak these, and reading and speaking is two different things, you know what I mean? Like, this is why you read the Bible, you know, and listen to the Quran. But, you know, like, I was supposed to speak these things, and I had paid for this website, you know, and I didn't have any material to give the person that was supposed to be building the website for me. You know, I didn't understand. And so, you know, I just gave them a whole bunch of, I just gave them the sermons, you know, and told, you know, gave them some pictures, and I don't know, I may try to explain to them what I wanted, you know, you know, generically, right? And so all he did was put my fucking sermons on each page, you know what I mean? I mean, like, and so it's okay, you know. And so, like, now that he, like, now I kind of understand how to do it, you know what I mean? Like, I could edit it and go in there, you know. Like, I still need source material, you know, but, you know, right, I'm done. I'm not going to be motivating speaking to you guys. I'm not going to be telling you shit, you know what I'm saying? I don't give a fuck. I'm going to get on here and talk about whatever I want to talk about at the time. If you get something from it, great. If you don't, whatever, you know. I ain't got all day, you know. And like I said before, my brother reminds me of this, right? And so the girl didn't let him in, right? So he goes over my dude's house, right? And right, he called me yesterday, right? Asked me, was I home? You know what I'm saying? I'm like, not really, you know. And so he like, all right. And then that was that. And so I could see, you know what I'm saying, I could see all this shit coming, you know what I mean? My sister called me today, you know, right, blah blah blah. And so he comes and get the money. Now, all right, he wakes me up because I just went to sleep, like I said, and he already called me. They kept me up, like I was falling asleep after being up all night. And I'm talking about like 7 or 8 o'clock in the morning, been up all night, you know what I mean? Like, because that shit that I put out yesterday, you know, was fucking with me. And so, you know, just fall asleep, call me, all right, so I know you're coming, boom, boom, boom. So I'm on the couch, you know, and however that goes. So, you know, he comes, you know, I give him a 50, like, right, you know, you want a beer? I'm like, no, you know, because I know he want to stay and all that, whatever. So he leaves, you know, and so I thought he would have went back over Reggie house, but I guess he went over somewhere else, you know, supposed to be Kinsman somewhere over one of his dude's house. Now, this motherfucker comes knocking, well, comes, you know, at my window. I don't know how long it was. I mean, like, I had just got up, you know what I mean? So I went to sleep when he left, and, you know, I had just got up, went to the store. Right, I don't know how long it was. I mean, like 6 or 7 hours, right? And here he go, talking about he gave somebody $30 to stay with them for 2 fucking days. And the dude left, and then his he was asleep, or I don't know what he said, but his girl got the tripping. The dude girl got the tripping, talking about he gotta go, and they don't go. You don't give, right? What? Huh? Ugh. Right? So, and I can't take this shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I'm like, I'm no better than my mother. You know what I mean? Like, it's no, I am better than my mother. I have more empathy. I do believe, you know, I just, you know, like, I don't know what to tell y'all. Because the thing is this, right, you see, you know, like I said, like how he is, you know what I mean? And like all of this stuff to me is, you don't understand the fact that your relationship is over, okay? You don't have anything right now, you know what I mean? You're 33 years old, you're too old to be asking anybody for any help, okay? Now, who's your family? Right, fuck all of y'all talking about family, you know what I'm saying? Black people, niggas, it's supposed to be about community. Your family is fucked up, okay? So I don't want to hear that shit about no fucking family, okay? Because the whole time, right? So it's this thing here. This is, man, you ever been mind fucked, okay? So I'm tired. I'm tired of all that shit, okay? You grown, you know what I'm saying? You want to, right? If I bring something up, I brought something up from like a few years ago, right? Because I'm like, right? Because he talk about they put him out. You know, like, you know, the girl put him out and shit like that. I'm like, nigga, ain't no way, you know, somebody gonna put me out. I paid somebody $30 to tell my dude bounce and all this shit. No more, he got player. Oh, I was like, you know what I'm saying? Playing that victim shit. You know what I'm saying? That's that bitch shit. You know what I'm saying? That's what women do. You know, and he don't, like, we done had all these conversations. You know what I'm saying? We done fought. You know what I'm saying? A couple times, few times, okay? May have to tell you about that shit too. You know what I mean? Because this is leads to all of this. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, you know what I'm saying? Want to play? Oh, I got to play. Oh, yeah. I was the fool, you know, and I shouldn't have did this, and I shouldn't have, you know what I mean? Like, come on with the games. You know what I'm saying? You ain't paid nobody $30, you know what I'm saying, for 2 days, okay? This nigga don't pay. This nigga, he's the most, right, I said it to him. He's the most, oh, you think I'm dollar bill, but I ain't. Like, right, you don't pay no country boy shit. This nigga shicey as fuck. You know what I'm saying? Don't pay for nothing. You know what I'm saying? You can pay somebody $30, right? You got $50, right? So where the other 20 go, right? Right, you know he drunk when he come over here, right? And so you all in your emotions, you know what I'm saying? That nigga ain't no Clemens. I don't know who the fuck he is, you know what I mean? We all alike, you know? And so, right. And so want to talk about, you know, oh, he, you know, I don't want to hear that shit, you know what I'm saying? Buddhist, man. Right, where are my fucking effects at? Buddhist, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to hear shit, you know, like, because I told you what to do, you know what I mean? I told you what you need to do, you know, right? And so, $50, right? Now, oh, you come back now, you broke. What you trying to tell me? You broke? I just gave you $50, right? Oh, then we, right, later on, he gonna talk about, you ain't give me nothing. That was Rakia. I like, oh, okay. So I ain't give it to you, right? Because, right, you ain't think that I had the choice when she called me and say, no, I ain't got it right now. I've been calling you for 2 weeks. And, you know what I'm saying? You act like, you know what I mean? You can't return my calls, you know, to get the money in the first place. You know what I mean? Like, I couldn't have said that, you know, because I know the next thing she gonna say is that, give it to you. You know what I mean? Well, I'm already damn near broke myself, you know what I mean? A whole month ago, ain't got no food. And so all of that, right? He knows all of this stuff. But that doesn't matter. You know what I mean? And so, right. And so it's like, slowly, you know what I'm saying? The comment, I can't, you know, like, you would have to see it live and live in color to know what I'm talking about. But it's slowly but surely, he, you know, is, you know, it's everybody else's fault, you know? What did I do? You know what I'm saying? This nigga actually, right. And this was, and like, and then, you know, I'm yelling back at him, and then I try to be quiet. Then he, you know, I tell him to be quiet, because I don't want, I just told him to be quiet. You know what I mean? Like, he didn't even have to leave, nothing like that. You know what I mean? But I just don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear your sad story. You know what I'm saying? I just gave you $50 earlier today. You didn't, you know what I'm saying? Right, my sister, okay, so, but you broke. And then you ain't gave nobody $30 to stay in a fucking place for 2 days, okay? And what was you going to do after the 2 days? You know what I mean? He don't want to answer that, you know what I mean? And like, it's all of this stuff. And then, what did I do? I ain't did nothing to nobody. You know, oh, I guess it's karma. I'm like, okay, so what does karma mean? What does karma mean, right? So, right, because this is a car, because, right, because the whole point is, right, you won't stop talking, won't stop trying to explain itself like me, right? But the thing is this, already saying, I told you what to do already, you still don't want to do it, you want to do it your way, and then you want to come back and say, oh, it didn't work out, you know what I'm saying? And so, you know, I'm back again. Like, nigga, no, you know what I'm saying? I told you, you know what I'm saying? I told you what to do, you know? You lead the horse to water, right? You know, I told you what to do, you know? Don't do it right. Don't do what you want to do. Do it how I see it in my head. You know, it's 1, 2, 3, you know, you need to stop drinking. You need to get yourself together. You know what I'm saying? 30 days. You know what I mean? Fuck that bitch. You know what I'm saying? You don't have anything, so you ain't lost nothing. You know, you don't have nothing. Y'all putting me out in the streets. And then, right, then it's me, my sister, and my, and right, we all together. It's all everybody against him. You know what I mean? And then it's, right, he mad because my mother don't want to talk to him, right? And so you got to go through my sister, you know what I'm saying? That didn't hurt his feelings, you know what I'm saying? All the, you know what I'm saying? All this shit, right? He really mad at my mama and the nigga, you know what I'm saying? But I'm the only one that he can actually try to take shit out on, you know what I'm saying? And I ain't on this shit, you know what I'm saying? I'm not on it. I'm too sick, you know what I'm saying, to be sitting up here arguing because we going to fight because I'm going to swing on you, you know what I'm saying? And I can't beat him right now, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was sick last time we fought, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, but the whole thing is about, oh, you know, because I don't have room and patience and food and money, right? I'm not able to take care of you, sir, at 33 years old, you know? And so, right. Right, him and my sister, right, are like Mexican twins, you know what I'm saying? So he's, you know what I'm saying, he the baby of the family, so he wanna talk about that shit, you know what I'm saying? Oh, somebody asked me, you know what I'm saying, all of that bullshit, that shit that he got from my mama, you know what I'm saying, from her orphan ass, you know what I'm saying, and always talking about, you know what I'm saying, her parents dying, you know what I'm saying, all that shit trickled down to us, you know, my God. And so this nigga, you know what I'm saying, he's incapable, you know what I mean, of understanding. And like, we've been going through this shit, you know, his whole life. People have personalities, you know what I'm saying? I was 14 when this nigga was born, you know? And so, right. And so, I take him someplace, right? where he can get a good night rest, right, and get himself together. Ain't put him out, you know what I'm saying, and all this. And so this is, he has the nerve to say, I ain't never did you like this. I ain't never did you like this. I what did I do? La, 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 la. So, I'm going to tell y'all something, right? I got out of jail October 21st, 2008, a couple weeks before Barack Obama was voted president. I made it for that. You see what I'm saying? I ain't right, whatever. So, right, in between, right, my mother, right, because can't stay with my mother for too long. You know what I'm saying? She opened the door, but then she makes it her job and her duty to make you uncomfortable as possible so you get the fuck out, okay? Door always open, you know what I'm saying? But, right, do you really want to come in? You know what I'm saying? No, you don't. You know, and so, right, and that's how, right, that's the good and bad, right, of a guy, you know what I'm saying? Oh, the door always open, but am I actually welcome? You know what I'm saying? No, you know? And so, right, you know, must, whatever, however, right. So, you know, right, she passed me off, you know what I'm saying, to my sister, basically, all right? And so, my sister, this was, right, she, like, 24, 25 at the time. Well, I don't say 22, 23, okay? And, you know, I guess this was her first apartment, you know? So she don't, you know what I mean? Like, right, she been at home the whole time, though, you know? Patrick been gone to Job Corps and then went to living off bitches, you know what I'm saying? But she was at home the whole time. So she got her little spot. So here I come home from jail, you know, and it's like, you know, she, you know, she mean. She, like, she nice, but she, like, she's a, like I said, she's a generic version of my mother, you know what I mean? I don't know how to explain that. But anyway, she a Capricorn. So they kind of weird anyway, as far as girls go, right? And so, you know, I just got out of jail. October 21st, okay? And so, I don't know what to tell y'all. It's like, I was going, you know what I'm saying, like, not trying to be a burden on too many people. So, I'm going between my brother and sister house, got my job, you know what I'm saying, got my job back. Right, after the 2 years that I went to jail, this is the same job that I came home and got again, because that's how fucking good I was at sales, you know? So, you know, this is $2,000-$3,000 a month again, okay? But, right, people don't give you time, you know what I'm saying? Like, one thing about, like, Alcoholics Anonymous, you know, is about, like, how they say that you have to cut yourself off from people because you can't make up, you know what I mean? You can't, you know, and people are always going to remind you of your mistakes, you know what I mean? They're always going to remind you of your mistakes, like I did with my brother today, you know, but whatever. Because, right, like, another thing, Frank, you know, or right, on Shameless, when Fiona was going through her shit and Frank told her, you a mean drunk, you know, the other thing was her friend, you know, she asked her friend, damn, what's the black girl name? V. She asked V, you know, could she stay over at her house because her brother had put her out because, you know, like, after her, it's him, you know what I'm saying? Like, right, she number one, he number two, you know what I'm saying? But he became, like, he's a man number one, you know? So he, you know, he was right behind her trying to take care of things, but he was an alcoholic. So he been in AA for, like, you know, 2, 4, 5 seasons, you know what I'm saying? He been in AA. And so he was telling V that you need to, don't let her stay, you know what I'm saying? She need, you know what I'm saying? She don't need, like, she need to hit rock bottom. She need, you know what I'm saying? She needs, you know what I'm saying? She don't need any more, what you call it, when you codependent, what is enablers, you know what I'm saying? She doesn't need any more enablers, you know? So he told her, that she shouldn't let her stay there. And like, you know what I'm saying, she struggled with it, you know what I mean, like, that's my girl, like, I can't do her like that, such 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 such, you know what I'm saying. But at the end of the day, she understood and she denied her, you know what I mean. And it, right, Fiona was devastated, you know what I mean, hurt, you know what I mean. But I don't know if it was like the next episode, however time goes, you know what I mean, she showed her ass up at an AA meeting with her brother, you know what I mean, like, she just popped in and he saw her, you know, however. And so she's on a road to recovery. And my point is, like, my brother came over here with his fucking sad story. You know what I mean, I just gave you $50 earlier, right? Oh, my sister gave it to him, okay? It just passed through my hands, okay? So my sister gave him $50 earlier, and like, not even 6-7 hours later, you come over here talking about you broke.